trot this cross rail. Adjust your equipment now. I know some of you want to jump with draw reins. That's okay for small jumps. When we get bigger, I want to take them off. Let's come down over the cross rail, two at a time. So if you stay over right there in position, two at a time, maybe 6 horse lengths apart. Cross rail, right turn to the Cavalletti line. Ready? Short approach, just around the yellow, around the yellow. Two at a time, so get a little closer now. That's fine. Then the other horses move up so you're in position.
جهزوا نفسكم الاثنين اللي بعدهم.
Now wait for him to catch up so I see both of you through here and wait for a minute. Okay? Like it? That's the rein, yes. That's the opening rein, that's exactly right. That horse drifts left, right rein opens, next two. Right rein opens, and left leg closes. It's a holding leg, it's not a driving leg. It's a holding leg, right at the girth, back into the girth. That was correct. Okay. As the horse leaves the ground, then you help me out with names. Achman, when he leaves the ground, I want you to soften up a little bit. Don't pull back with the reins. These are gymnastics. That's it. No, don't release and over-release. Watch me for a second. Here, ride to me. Next two. Here, try here, quick. Next two, halt. What I mean, halt, next two. What I mean is, as the horse leaves the ground.
Hold it, walk. Hold it, walk. Hold.
Hold. Hold up, and hold up like you're jumping. You keep contact with his mouth. I want you all to keep contact. The horse takes your hand, you follow it with connection. That's the, of course you want to know how to master that. So you follow, watch boys. You follow with connection, right? Alongside the neck. Now, what I'm saying is don't pull back as he leaves the ground. You did it over the first jump, you didn't over the second, but then you over-released. Yeah, so just keep the connection, and as the horse leaves the ground in a gymnastic, let him figure it out, don't help him. Next. Next two.
Next.
That one chestnut horse where it's so tied down, we want to watch him once more in unleash him. That horse. Let's unleash that horse. You know, take the all that equipment off. Hey, ride over here to me for a second. Names.
Abdul, Obad.
And chestnut horse, let me see him over here too.
Neither.
I'll get the names in over 3 days, but I haven't focused too much on it now. You do something strange in the air with your hands. You follow like this. You aware of that? You seen pictures like that? Yes. So, hold the reins normal, a little longer. All right, don't curl your wrists like this. You just stay, relax. No, we're gonna jump. Hold up, hold on, hold on, hold up. Like you're jumping. Uh-huh, pretend you're jumping. Straight wrist. Don't curl your wrists like that. All right, work on that. It's just a habit, right? Little habit. Next, yeah, let me see what you got here on leash. Now, what about a running martingale on him? No? You ever use a running?
It's a Kibble 11. You can put it right now.
Let's put a running on. What do we have, two more?
Yes. Now, don't show me.
If I say fold up from the hips in the air, I mean this. From the hips in the air, so you're a little closer to the horse's neck. See you two upright. Look at, watch me, come here. That's very nice. Very nice. Yeah, right over here. I'll put that straight across. About, across here, about this high. That is 90 centimeters. So, jumping position. Jumping position, that's a half seat position. And as you jump, you fold up from the hips, right? Go ahead, show me how you jump. You're too erect in the air. Fold up a little bit more. Yes, and your arms follow. You fold up and follow. So this will be important over a big oxer, right? It's your ability to stay with your horse, yeah? And encourage him to clear that hind rail, yeah. So I just get suspicious if you're looking like that a little bit on over a small jump. Can you do it over a wide jump? You know what I mean? So I don't know. I don't know. And we need one more pole. One more pole here.
Okay.
One down. Okay, boys. All right, same thing. Let's go three at a time. Three horses at a time, please. And just wait down there, wait. Good, come. It's a bounce, as you know. All right, now center him. I want you to be very particular about the middle. Right, very particular about the middle. Just name again.
Second one.
Hoppin'. You're doing what I hate in America. Whoever entered that crest release, I hate that for advanced riders. When you're pressing in the neck for balance, you're pushing in the horse's neck for balance, you're jumping with your hands pressed in his neck. I want you to get off the neck and keep contact and practice that over little jumps. And you'll get comfortable with it. In 6 months, you'll be an artist with contact. But if you keep resting on the neck, it just never ever happens, you know what I mean? So just separate your arms wider, so there's no chance you're going to press wide, straight line. I say straight line for practice. Broken line in the ring is fine, but a straight line for practice. Next. Tidy it up, boys. You're way too far away. It takes forever to get to this little jump. Get right there by that pile of jumps so we're ready to go. You know, get right up there where you're ready by that pile of jumps. That's it. Stay with that horse. And hold up there. Okay, bring him here. Let me see that martingale. Let me see your equipment. Come here. Hold up for a sec. He's not the one that had the shamble, is he? Okay, let's take this rein, and just for an experiment for me, let's see, because he throws his head so hard with the leverage, let's see if he's any different on the top rein. Because a leverage bit will do that sometimes. Sometimes they give you automatic flexion. Yes. A horse goes two ways in a leverage bit. He accepts the leverage, or he goes this way. And because he threw his head a couple times when he took his mouth hard, this way and not this way with pole flexion, I'm suspicious of whether it's useful or not. Yes. So let's see. The only way you find out is to try it. Very straight. I like wide hands. You all have wide hands. Don't curl your wrists in the air. Don't curl. No, you're still curling your fingers in the air. It's a funny habit. You need to watch yourself on video and use a driving rein. Use a driving rein. Just canter. Go ahead forward. Just let him loosen up a little. He wants to play a little. That's all right. Canter around a little. Get him a little loose. We didn't do much warm up. I know that. We don't have time. All right. Next jump, boxer. Who is it does this? Which boy does this? Raise your hand. Yeah. You know, that's, come here, I'll show you a way out of that. Not tonight, but sure. Well, maybe tonight, yeah. We'll do it tonight. No ground line on this. Nope. No ground line. It's called a driving rein. We hold the reins in two fingers. Like this. And two fingers. Yeah. Separate your hands. Point your thumb at the bit. Point your thumb at the bit when you jump. So a wide hand. Relax. Wide hand. Like that when you jump. This way. You got it? Yeah, now, boxer here. Practice like that a couple times. Let's see if it helps. And listen, I'm just going to mention that to you. We're not going to dwell on that. Oh, okay, fine. We're not going to dwell on it. If you're interested. Say again. Nice to meet you. How are you? Oh, fabulous. Fabulous place. Fabulous place. I never in my wildest dreams thought I'd see this. Fabulous. Okay, boys. Go up two of that. Ready?
Just change before the takeoff on the left. Jump always on the left.
That's fine.
Okay.
That, you know, if a horse prefers a particular lead. Go ahead, boys. Do it at the period of time. If he prefers the lead, that's fine. He prefers it. He's stronger on that lead. Well, I don't like the drift. I don't like the drift, but. And that's this horse? Hold up now. The little details we mentioned, I want you to work hard on trying to fix. Fold up over the jump more. Exaggerate it. Exaggerate. keep coming. Exaggerate that cold. The driving range is very old. You can keep coming, you don't have to circle. It's a driving range. Your reins are a little long. So, is it possible now to take the shim off? Yeah, let's unleash him a little. Let's unleash him. Have we all done this? Boys, have we all done this? All right, next part. Next part goes up.
Amen.
That's where?
أنا عايز
يس Boys, this gets a little tight, so use your voice. This last part will get a little tight, use your voice. I want to start by cantering this Liverpool. Oh, no, I don't. Let's do this little count exercise. You need that. But trot through there once. Let me see him when he's unleashed. Up through the, no, just the gymnastic.
What's that, man?
A little more.